which is we don't understand why they picked it.
Okay,
they have some reason.
Theory craft with me. Where does Secret's win come from if it's a win?
We still have that top lane battle. The PA going up against the puck. Universe being really up in his face. Like, he's orbing whenever he possibly can. He's spending more time attacking MP than he's attacking Crits, and he's still actually getting more bottom lane. Crits in trouble. Very, very low. The attack from Yapzor will be able to spill the first blood. Fantastic for Yapzor, as he'll be able to buy up his boots, which makes his rotations a lot easier.
Yeah.
This is where you get really great synergy between both mid one as well as Yapzor. You start the static link, pick him up and throw him back in again, which means mid one gets the maximum stolen damage. There's still a decent amount of damage coming out from the illusions, but it won't be enough. Mid one will take the kill on Samael in middle lane, and Yapzor's influence felt once more. Bottom lane, Keizu getting stunned up, and now upheaval once again from Crit. Puffy needs to slow this down. He lead seeds on Arteezy, so Arteezy can't keep pumping out the damage into Keizu.
That's the way to go. Push out the lane, prevent Razor from being able to chase you down with Static Link. It stops ganks as well. It's just a really safe place to be for Sumel.
Keizu's trying to cut his way through. He's trying to stop Arteezy from just having an easy defense, but here's your first rotation. It's Universe, the bottom lane Dream Call. On the Keizu, remember, he's low. He wants to reach the side shop and pick up his Arcane Boots. He's got the money for it. Doesn't want to have to lose this. He's going to get in range in time, so he'll have his Arcane Boots. Try and break free with a crack, and it won't happen.
That wasn't that bad. I'm really glad you pointed out the arcanes, because that kind of was just salvation for him. He gets gold lanes generally.
Mid lane, Zai. Oh, nice grab. He's actually pulling Zai closer towards the tier 1 tower. Yapzor, the attack was coming from behind. A quick little invis, and there's no money from Yapzor. He always gets greedy. Dream Coil into mid 1. Light Striker Ray is going to connect, and then just Laguna Blade delete him. Zai, critted up by MP, has to Burrow Strike up into the Radiant side of the river. He'll have to commit Ravage if he wants to survive this. In fact, he won't survive this at all. The damage output is just way too high with Arteezy and Sumail.
I mean, Sumail's already got plus 43 damage with his right clicks. And he's got a passive ult. They're going to play
mid-1 TP'd
with
over. Yapzor wants to crack at this. Light Strike Array, he'll dodge it. Now the Static Link.
Okay.
Lina's going to fall. Mid-1 will take his life. Can look towards Arteezy with a gust as well as a slow. They need to have another control. You don't have the telekinesis up, and Arteezy relearns without this T1 tower.
Because we haven't seen a lot of output from him.
Burrow Strike, it's nice. Yapzor picking up Zai once more. Going to return Burrow Strike. Cancelling off the Sandstorm. Where is that Ravage? The Ravage will pop. Arteezy hit on it. Zai not done, but MP able to get the crit. Rock will drop. Laguna Blade, they're trying to kill off Yapzor. Unsuccessful. Yapzor will turn around. Burrow Strike on Samael. Just trying to cancel off a large portion of this damage. But Zai is back to the world of the living. He buys back for it. Moving in deeper. They need to set up on MP, and they're able to get it. Razor, mid one can't survive. One more attack from Universe. Will do it. Mid one on the run. He could potentially deny himself the edge. It won't happen. Universe will reach him in time. A double kill for Universe.
Gank.
The
only target they've really got is going to be Crit. If Yapzor can close the distance to get the telekinesis, they do have a chance for it and see if they can bait EG into a fight. But Yapzor, he does get the crit. Pick him up, throw him back in. Mid one, Static Link straight away. The rock will drop the space. It has to be created. Stolen up perfectly from Yapzor. The return chaotic offering combining up with the Ravage. Now a Sable Genius is in trouble. Mid one, the double kill. Arteezy trying to bring down the Razor, able to do so with the help of the gold. Burrow Strike from Zai creating space into the epicenter. MP needs life, needs support. Five, and he jumped forward, he's able to do so, but Arteezy will kill him off. A point blank range arrow to the knee. They'll start retreating. Keizu running up the river. Samael's got the Light Strike Array, but Keizu picks up a haste rune, the perfect rune for escaping. And the amount of damage they've got, mid one's looking, but he doesn't really want to go into this one just yet. Neither does the Phantom Assassin.
She
doesn't have her big items, but yep, the Scout, Burrow Strike, Zai goes in, the Dream Call is perfect. Universe with a three-man silence, catching Rubick on the back lines as well. Tidehunter trying to beat that frontline tank, but they don't care. They move the back line. Zai will 4K into the attacks up the hill from Samael. He's just pumping into Team Secret from a bad position, but it still may be enough. Living Armor and Upheaval, they can't do enough. Razor is falling and will go down. The Ancients deny him in the middle of the fight. It may not matter. A kill is a kill. Universal grab another one too. Back to the tier 2 tower. And MP, the only one to survive. EG claim both Roshan, Aegis into Samael, and four heroes from Team Secret. There's living armor on MP under the cover of smoke. They don't have an opportunity yet. Observer Ward is down, so now they see nicely.
And they'll probably assume that the
heroes the jump in. Zai, Burrow Strike. It only goes on top of mid one. Quickly jumps away, but MP gets the crit. Dropping Zai down to half. Five. Keizu, the Ravage will be committed. It catches onto crit. They need to bring down crit as well before that Warlock Rock will drop, but they can't move out. MP with the double kill, but Arteezy pumping out the damage. They need a little bit more, and they've got it. MP will fall, and Team Secret. Puppy has no trees to hide on, living armor or not. He can't go invis in time. Three heroes, however, from EEG. That is not as many as they really wanted to lose.
Yeah, they didn't kill all the perfect heroes. They killed all the supports, but the big damage dealers, the ones that can easily take Roche, are still alive, so it's like a repeat of the fight earlier.
You've got Yapsel to scout out with Illusionary Orb. Mid one at his BKB. He will commit it. They want the kill on Arteezy. Mid one's going to steal all the damage with the help of Yapsel. They held him in position.
Oh,
mid one, the damage from Samael is so high. Yapsel with the Illusionary Orb, however, will end up getting a kill. He'll get stunned up by the Last Strike Array. He needs more time. He can't get out of the pit. Can he play the Fog of War around the tree? Samael! He can't finish the job. Yapsel, living armor. He doesn't jump to the orb. He jukes Samael as well. He went left. The orb went right. And Samael had a choice.
They're back up, only missing Razor, but Arteezy is still dead from 46. And a pretty good fight for Secret,
on the Forest Strike, they've gone in again on the Tree Protector. No Overgrowth available. The dust will reveal, but MP jumps forward. The Rock, it's still there. Keizu reduces the damage with the Anchor Smash. But Samael on the back lines, he needs to get up the ramp. But then Yapsel again! He's in the back lines! He caught him in the back! MP, he'll get up the hill. A quick jump up. The trigger the Shrine, looking for the regeneration. Mid one, stealing the damage away from Zai. Zai not getting attacked fast enough. But Yapsel, he looks for the kill. He body blocks up crit. He's got Fate Bolt and Dragon Slave. The damage is enough to allow Mid One to capitalize on the situation.
Puck's gonna try to punish him though, but he's got so much magic resistance.
Oh, is he gonna jump? The silence is actually holding Yapsel. The Golem's trying to help out. MP and Keizu in the meantime, they're inside of Roshan, going for Roshan. Zai will jump in. Sandstorm, where's your reveal? I'm not seeing a Sentry Ward anywhere near close enough to it, but he will still fall out of the pit, outside the Sandstorm. But Golem will time out in 12 seconds time for the bigger one, catching MP on the back lines. He needs
so
this
dead.
Heal. He needs to stay alive, but he cannot do it. The stun too good from EG in mid one. That attack from Samael, it'll be enough. Reaching up the hill, no mischance. He also blinked up to ensure the kill nonetheless. So two big cores, the big ones from Team Secret, are down, and finally EG will claim Roshan on it. And the pressure will continue again. The buyback did come out from Arteezy.
And BKB was used on Lina, so she's perhaps the vulnerable one, but that was Ravage, so they don't have their
own. And
ultimates.
Overgrowth, they committed both. Yapsel, the pickup, it's Samael.
Oh,
you said Lina was the problem one. Zykirias, a little bit of space for the Burrow Strike, catching MP as well. Mid one, Punterfield doesn't make enough space. Tidehunter trying to retreat, but Arteezy is focusing him down. Silence Keizu, the attack will reach him. They have to jump back in again. You've got a deep universe in very, very far. Yapsel and Mid one able to combine together to a gem. It'll be a trade-off for a trade-off. In fact, I think that gem actually just stolen. It was Zai's. So EG lost the detection, but Arteezy, he was the main target they're trying to go on, but they jump in further. The stun's on Arteezy. They want more kills. Zai's getting back out again with the Lacuna Blade. Mid one will fall, and they've got more. MP can jump up towards Puppy. Fire Strike over on Rubick. The Sandstorm giving him the invis to escape back up to the high ground. Mid one also buying back. They got issues on top of their tier 4 towers. In fact, I can't say towers plural. They're down to one.
I'm glad it wasn't Overgrowth, that would have been way too costly, but this is a really abusable thing you can do with tree. Blink, and then before you become visible, despite being away from trees, you get the root.
There's a Lotus Orb again out in the Drow Ranger.
Ooh,
you Burrow Strike
trouble.
Forward, you'll stun him up, here goes your Ravage. Can they kill off the Drow Ranger? Lotus Orb has worn off mid one, can't actually get a proper static link, he didn't get anything in the rock. Connects on almost all of Team Secret, in comes the Epicenter from Zai. It's the icing on the cake, Razor is down for 2 minutes. Puppy, Overgrowth creates a little bit of space, but Tidehunter, he'll go down. Buyback is available, he may as well use it. It's all or nothing now for Team Secret. They're forced deep inside the base. It's a stolen epicenter for Yapsel, but he has to wait for his blink dagger to come off cooldown for him to use it. But he's losing too many teammates too quickly, and it's still only now just called GG. Yapsel will go back in again, but it appears the cameraman says this game is over already.
And it is definitely over. They tried really hard to take a good fight there, but EG was just a step ahead every single time that mid one blinked forward with the Razor. His opponents did the exact same thing, getting out. And because of that, it just became difficult for them to fight. They had a lot of good opportunities in the top lane, but they didn't want to mess around with the Aegis. And then on bot lane, they said, we have